Hi, I'm Kellie Stenzel, Golf Magazine Top 100 Teacher. Here we are in a greenside bunker with a relatively high lip in front of us. And what have a lot of us been taught? Open the club face, walk the body around so we're opening the body, swing down the shoulder line, giving the ball spin and lift. That's all correct, and believe me, I teach that to some of my players. But what I'm saying is, this may not be necessary for most golfers. Understand that your sand wedge, as it's built, probably already has plenty of loft to easily clear these lips in front of you. So if I take this club and I set it on the ground and I step on the face, the angle of the shaft as it leaves this club head is basically going to show me the angle that the ball will leave the club face when I'm splashing sand greenside. So if I set this club squarely, understand there are markings on this club to help me to do that. So when I look at what my club has, if I see the writing in the center of the grip, when I go ahead and place my hands on the club, I'm going to make sure that this writing stays right in the center. So I'll keep that straight, and I'll go ahead and place my hands on the club. Now this club face is square. You can see the writing's right in the middle here. But understand, what can be a little confusing is square looks open. This is 56 degrees. So square can look open, and in most cases, is plenty of loft. So I'll go ahead and put that writing on the top. I'll place my hands relatively high on the club, and I'm going to go ahead and practice my forward swing, because that's the important motion. I want to keep that club into the sand for as long as possible, because the longer the divot that I make in the sand, and I'm looking for somewhere around 12 to 15 inches, the better my chance for success. So from a good setup, hands high, ball position left, digging my feet into the sand, I'm just going to practice my forward swing. We'll call it a scrape drill. So I take my setup, I keep the club head into the sand on the semicircle for as long as I can, all the way through to my full finish. Notice that's a really long, nice divot. And I'm going to practice that several times, because this is the proper motion for getting the ball up and into the air out of a greenside bunker. So set up, scraping the sand, semicircle to full finish. Once again, notice that nice, long path of sand that I'm taking. And I'm going to keep practicing that until I really feel like I have a good sense of it. Now understand from there, the rest is easy, because you can take your normal golf swing and with a good setup, feeling the scrape feeling, produce beautiful high lofted bunker shots. So my setup's going to be, once again, hands high, ball position forward. I'm going to go ahead and dig my feet into the sand. And what that does is that lowers the bottom of my swing and helps me to take sand. From there, I'll make my regular backswing, add my typical forward momentum, but keeping that feeling of scrape. And that will get that golf ball nice and up and out of here. My regular swing, nice full finish, regular finish, and that ball easily clears that lip. So understand how your sand wedge works. So setting the club face square, writing in the center, ball position forward, digging in, that feeling of the scrape drill, club along the sand, all the way to a good full finish, will produce beautiful bunker shots. The better your setup and the better your understanding, the more likely you are to have success and more fun out there on the golf course.